Good morning, students. Welcome to the biology class. We are continuing with our same chapter, structural organization in animals, that is animal tissue. And today we are going to start with second very important animal tissue, that is your connective tissue. What are the various features of the connective tissue? As the name indicates, they bind or link different tissues and organ together and support them. They are most abundant and widely distributed tissues in an animal body. There are three major components in a connective tissue. Number one is cells, fibers, and matrix. So what do you mean by the cell? The cells are loosely arranged or widely separated from each other by extracellular material called matrix. There are three types of the cell. Number one is fibroblast. Number two is mast cell. And the third one is a macrophage. So these are the three types of the cell which are being present in the connective tissue. Fibers. The fibroblast, which is one of the cell of the connective tissue, they secrete the fibers, that is collagen and elastin proteins. These fibers are distributed along with the cell in the matrix, and these fibers provide tensile strength, elasticity and flexibility to the tissues. And the third component is matrix, that is your ground substance. It is composed to glycoproteins secreted by the tissue cells. So with these three components, we are having the tissue that is known as your connective tissue. Here you can see the classification of connective tissue. Connective tissue divided into three parts, that is proper connective tissue, supportive connective tissue, and fluid connective tissue. Under the proper connective tissue, we are having a loose connective tissue and dense connective tissue. Under the loose connective tissue, we will study areolar connective tissue, adipose connective tissue, and white fibrous connective tissue. Under the dense connective tissue, we will study the dense regular connective tissue, that is your tendon and ligament, and dense irregular connective tissue. So they are regular, they are irregular depending upon the arrangement of the fibers. So the supportive connective tissue, that is your bone, which is the hardest part of our body, and cartilage, which is rigid but flexible. So that is compact bone and spongy bone, and hyaline cartilage, fibrocartilage, elastic cartilage. And the third part of your connective tissue is fluid connective tissue, under which we study the blood and lymph. So first we are taking the proper connective tissue, that is your loose connective tissue, and they are of three types, that is areolar. The first one is your areolar connective tissue. It consists of three types of cell and two types of protein fibers, all distributed in the matrix. So earlier we studied that we are having a three components of connective tissue, that is cell, fibers, and matrix. So how they are being arranged and what function they are performing. Fibroblast, which is one of the cell of the connective tissue, are irregularly shaped flat cells with long protoplasmic processes. They secrete collagen and elastin protein for fibers. Collagen fibers have tensile strength and also help tissue in repairing, means during the wear and tear, the collagen fibers, they play the very important role. Elastin fiber prevent displacement, injury of tissue due to the mechanical stress. So the second type of your cell is macrophages, are the large amoeboid, which is of irregular shape, that phagocytose, means that engulf the foreign particle and destroy the microbes, foreign particles, and the cells of damaged tissues. Mast cell, that is the third cell, are irregularly void and store inflammation, means sujan. producing substances like histamine as dense granule. In this image, you can see the three particular components are there. So this is matrix, which is a ground substance. In the matrix, you will find the three cells, that is fibroblast, which is producing the fibers, that is your collagen fiber or the white fibers, and this single and branch, that is your yellow fiber or your elastin fibers. And this is your amoeboid cell, that is macrophage, which used to digest or phagocytose the foreign particles, microbes, and protect our body from the foreign particles. And this is your mast cell, which store the inflammation and producing the substances, that is the histamine. The next is your adipose connective tissue, and it consists of collagen fibers, elastin fibers, fibroblast, macrophages, and adipocytes. So instead of mast cell, here we are having a third cell, that is your adipocytes, which store the fat. So in this image, you can see this is a fat droplets. These are your adipocyte cell. So this is your white fibers, this is your yellow fibers, collagen, or you can say the elastin are there. Along with that, you are having the adipocytes, you are having the macrophages, and you are having the fibers, and they all are present in the matrix. So adipose tissue synthesizes, stores, and metabolizes the fats. It prevents the heat loss by forming the insulating layer beneath the skin, and it also protects our vital organs because it provides a cushion-like covering around our vital organs like our ear, about our heart, and so on. The third is your white fibrous tissue. It has only few fibroblasts, as you can see in this image, and the dense network of thick collagen fibers, they are present in the bundles, as you can see, and they has a great tensile strength. It found in the joints between the skull bones, which made it immovable. The next comes to your dense connective tissue. After the loose connective tissue, the second part of your proper connective tissue is your dense connective tissue. The cells and the fibers, they are compactly packed. If the fibers are irregular in orientation, the tissue is called dense irregular, and it is found in the skin. And if fiber shows a regular orientation pattern, it is called as a dense regular connective tissue. For example, tendon and ligament. Tendon is a dense regular connective tissue that binds the muscle with the bone. So this is very important to learn, that tendon, which binds muscle with the bone, and the ligament, it is a dense regular connective tissue that attaches one bone to the other. So sometimes they said there is no fracture, but the ligament is ruptured. So that means the connection or the binding between one bone to the another bone is there and holds them in the position in the joints. So what is the difference between the tendon, which binds muscle with the bone, and ligament, which binds one bone with the another bone? In this image, you can see about the dense regular and irregular image, that is, they have a very regular pattern with the help of your cells are there, fibroblasts are there, you are having a white collagen fibers, and they are having the irregular pattern lying here and there, that is what called as a dense irregular connective tissue. So after finishing our loose connective tissue as well as our dense connective tissue, means the proper connective tissue, we are having a second part of our connective tissue, that is your supportive connective tissue. This tissue provides support to the organ concerned, and they provide protection to the vital organs, means very important organs. It helps in the movement and the locomotion along with the muscular tissue. And in this particular connective tissue, they include bones and cartilage. Bone. It is rigid, hard, inelastic, and strong connective tissue. Bone is surrounded by thick fibrous layer called periosteum. Matrix is made up of protein, that is osin, in addition to the calcium salt which make it hard. It bears bone marrow cavity where the blood cells are formed. Its matrix is calcified because of the presence of the calcium, and it occur in concentric layers called lamellae around the Haversian canal. Bone cells, they are of two, that is osteoblasts when they are immature, but when they become mature, they become osteocytes. Lacuna containing the osteocytes means the space are present in between the lamellae. Haversian canals carry blood vessels and the nerves. Osteocytes bone cell is irregular in shape and has protoplasmic processes. Each osteocyte is lodged in space called as a lacuna, which has projection called as canaliculi. The very important function and very simple function, it gives protection to the internal organs like your lungs, your heart. Bones provide place of the attachment of skeleton muscles and helps in movement and locomotion. Now in this image you can see the various parts of your bone, that is the transverse section of the bone, that is the thick outermost layer, that is your periosteum. Then you can see this is your Haversian canal, and these are your bone cells, that is your osteocytes, having the protoplasmic processes, that is your canaliculi, and they are being present in the concentric manner. So this is the concentric manner, and the space where they are being present, that is what called as your lacunae or interstitial lamellae. So these are your osteocytes, that is your endosternum, this is your periosteum, this is your endosteum, and you are having the Haversian canal, and the arrangement of the osteocytes in the concentric manner along with the lamellae, that is your Haversian lamellae, that is canaliculi is there. This is what called as your Haversian system. So we are having the cells, that is your osteocytes, we are having the matrix, that is your lacuna, and we are having the various, you can say, the protoplasmic processes coming out from the particular this is in the fibrous form. Next is your cartilage. It is soft and elastic. Cartilage is surrounded by thick fibrous layer, and it is called as the perichondrium, containing blood vessels. And it is made up of protein, that is chondrin. You can see the difference between the bone and cartilage too, that is your inelastic, hard and rigid, whereas the cartilage is soft and elastic. Bone is being surrounded by the thick layer that is known as your periosteum, and this is known as the perichondrium. The matrix is made up of protein osin, and here that is the chondrin, and no calcium salts are present, but the calcium salts are present in the bone. Cartilage cells are chondroblasts which do not have protoplasmic processes. Chondrocytes are bluntly angular and occur in clusters of two or three in each lacunae in the matrix. Matrix occur in homogeneous mass and lamellae are absent. Now what is the difference between your bone and cartilage? The bone is hard, rigid and inelastic, whereas the cartilage is soft and elastic. Number two, the bone is surrounded by the thick fibrous layer, that is your periosteum, and the cartilage is being surrounded by the perichondrium. The matrix is made up of protein osin, and this is made up of protein chondrin, and that is having no calcium salts, whereas the calcium salts are present in the matrix of your bone. Cartilage cells, they are the chondroblasts, whereas the bone cells, that is the osteoblasts. And the osteoblast or the osteocytes, they are having the protoplasmic processes, whereas there is no protoplasmic processes in the cartilage. So chondrocytes are angular and they occur in clusters without any protoplasmic processes, without any particular, you can say, the pattern, that is the concentric. They are in the cluster two or three in the lacuna present, And the matches occur in the homogeneous mass and lamellae absent, whereas the lamellae are the present in the bone. So this is your very important question, that differentiate between the bone and cartilage. So here you can see that is an outermost thick fibrous layer, that is your perichondrium. You are having a white fibers and the perichondrium is having the blood vessels. This is your matrix. This is the chondroblast that is in the lacunae, and they are present in the two or three clusters, not that is the individual. So the types of cartilage, that is hyaline cartilage, it is present in the tracheal rings, larynx and nasal septum. Then fibroelastic, it is present in between the adjacent vertebrae in the vertebral column. And elastic cartilage, it is present in epiglottis, ischial tube, pinna of ear. So you can see, you can just make the folds of your ear pinna, or you can just, you can have a folds of your nose. But still they will maintain the shape because of the cartilage. They are not rigid, they are soft and flexible, but still they maintain the shape. They are not having any particular bone in that, but still they maintain the shape. They are flexible, and that's why they are being known as a cartilage. So function is, it absorbs the stress and provides flexibility to the body part, that is your nose and ear pinna. And the last of your connective tissue is your fluid connective tissue. Fluid tissue is also being known as a vascular tissue. It consists of fluid matrix in which are suspended free floating cell, and matrix is devoid of fibers, means no fibers are present in the fluid connective tissue, flow freely, and it's not secreted by the cell it contains. So the fluid tissue, they include blood and lymph. The blood is the most important liquid connective tissue, which consists of aqueous mixture of the substances, that is the matrix, called as blood plasma. In blood plasma, the matrix are suspended different types of the free floating cells called as the blood corpuscles, and there are three types of the blood cells or the corpuscles, that is RBCs or erythrocytes, WBCs, that is white blood cells, or the leukocytes, platelets, or the thrombocytes. So we are having a three, that is RBCs, WBCs and platelets. So the function is, it is meant for transport, means RBCs are meant for transport of nutrients, hormones and the respiratory gases. WBCs add immunity to the body, and the platelets, they helps in the clotting of blood. And here you can see the various images of the blood cells. So this is erythrocyte, that is RBCs. They are red in color because of the presence of pigment, that is your hemoglobin. And then you are having the WBCs, that is your monocyte, lymphocytes having a single nuclei, neutrophils, multinucleated is there, eosinophil granules is there, and that is of a red color, that is acidophils, basophil, again the granules are there, and that is your basophil, that is blue in color, and that is eosinophil because of the red in color. Then we are having the macrophages and platelets. So they are the basically the blood corpuscles, that is your RBCs, your WBCs and your platelets. The lymph. Lymph is a colorless fluid tissue that acts as a middleman for transport of material between the blood and tissue cells. It has clear, colorless fluid matrix in which amoeboid WBC cells flow. No RBCs are there, no platelets are there. It carries material from tissues into the blood and vice versa, means from blood to the tissue. It protects the body against the infection by destroying the invading microorganism because they are having a WBCs. So in this image, you can see the various green color capillaries, that is your lymph capillaries. So how they are taking the material from your tissue and then to the blood, and from blood to the lymph, from lymph to the blood, and then from blood to the tissues. So in this way the exchange of the material takes place. So these are your lymph vessels, these are your veins, and this is your arteries, and the exchange takes place along with the blood vessels, that is your lymphatic capillaries, and they play the very important role in the exchange of the material from tissue to the blood vessel. So the another name of your lymph is the extracellular fluid, or you can say that is your tissue fluid. So our next lesson will be on the muscular and the nervous tissue. So till then, stay home, stay safe, stay healthy. Goodbye. Thank you.